The name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, welcome to this solemnity of All Saints. Whenever I celebrate this feast, I always think about Louis Armstrong, that big jazz man, who sung that beautiful song of the saints come marching in. But then, the best thing is, and then he said at the end, and may I be within that number. Let us ask the Lord that that song of Louis Armstrong may also come true for us, that one day we may be counted among the saints. In order to prepare ourselves now to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to eternal life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you for which we earnestly long. We make this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. First reading, a reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw another angel ascend from the rising of the sun with the seal of living God. And he called with a loud voice to the four angels who had been given power to harm earth and sea, saying, "Do not harm the earth or the sea or the trees till we have sealed the sevens of our God upon their foreheads." And I heard the number of the sealed, 140,000 sealed, out of every tribe of the sons of Israel. After this, I looked, and behold, a great multitude which no man could number, from every nation, from all the tribes and peoples and tongues, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes, with palm branches in their hands, and crying out loud with a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God, who sits upon the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood round the throne and round the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshipped God, saying, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving in honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these clothed in white robes, and from where have they come?" I said to him, "Sir, you know." And he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial psalm: these are the people who seek your face, O Lord.
These are the people who seek your face, O Lord.
The Lord's is the earth and its fullness, the world, and all who dwell in it. It is He who set it on the seas, on the rivers He made it firm.
These are the people who seek your face, O Lord.
Who shall climb the mountain of the Lord? Who shall stand in His holy place? The clean of hands and pure of heart, whose soul is not set on vain things.
These are the people who seek your face, O Lord.
Blessings from the Lord shall he receive, and right reward from the God who saves him. Such are the people who seek him, who seek the face of the God of Jacob.
Blessed are the people who seek your face, O Lord.
A second reading, a reading from the letter of Saint John. Beloved, see what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and so we are. The reason why the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. It does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And everyone who thus hopes in him purifies himself as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest, says the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
And glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, seeing the crowd, Jesus went up onto the mountain. And when he sat down, his disciples came to him. And he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when men revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends, I think it's not a coincidence that on the Feast of All Saints we have the Beatitudes. Because the Beatitudes, in fact, are a summary of all that a Christian should do if he wants to live according to the will of God and become a saint. So sometimes we are very caught up in all these blessed, and we forget the introduction to this Beatitudes. When Jesus went up to the mountain, and when he sat down, his disciples came to him, and he opened his mouth and taught them, saying. And I think this introduction is very, very important, because when the rabbis were teaching, most of the time they were walking around. But when they had something officially and very important to say, they sat on their seat. And we know the expression, the professor's seat. We know also still a long time ago when they were still talking, when the Pope spoke ex cathedra from his throne, that this also was officially and very important and binding. So that means that Jesus, when he sat down, it shows the people around him that he was going to say something what was very, very important and binding. That is the first thing. Then the second thing is, and he opened his mouth and taught them. This expression comes for sometimes in the Bible, meaning that when he opens his mouth, means he is really talking from his heart, from the desire that is deep down in his heart. And that is what Jesus did, and that is the reason why they say also when he opened his mouth, he told us what was most important that we should do in order to become a saint, in order to have the kingdom of heaven. And he taught them. We know that Jesus has been teaching us his whole life, has been teaching his disciples, and his disciples have been teaching us now. And that is also important that we should listen to them. So I'm just going to take a few of these blessed, because it would take too long to explain them all, but for me the first one is very, very important. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. It doesn't say like most of the other ones, for they shall receive, or they shall. Here it is, theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And why is that? If we realize that the poor in spirit are people who have nothing of themselves, they really are poor, not only bodily, but also in the spirit. The only thing they have and the only thing they rely upon and are dependent on is God's love. And of course, if somebody lives already like this here on earth, knowing that he cannot rely on his own power, he can only rely on the power and the love of God, of course, he is already in the kingdom of heaven. And then we have the second one, where it says, Blessed are the pure of heart. Now, pure of heart means, if we look into our own lives, how often do we good things without really thinking about other things. Most of the time we do things with mixed motives. I will help somebody because it makes me feel good. or I will help somebody, because then maybe sometime he will repay me for what I did for him today. It's very difficult to do good things with a real pure intention. And therefore it is also said that blessed are the pure, for they shall see God of heart. They shall see God. So let us ask the Lord that we may not only be poor in heart, but also pure in heart, so that we may receive the kingdom of heaven. Amen.
Amen.
Let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us now offer our petitions to God, our Heavenly Father, who is always willing to listen to us and grant us what we need if we pray in faith. Let us ask, first of all, that the Church may always be willing to take the Beatitudes as the core of their teaching, and may help the people to live accordingly. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us also ask for ourselves that in the Beatitudes we find everything we need to live a real Christian life, that we may have the courage, although some of them are very difficult to follow, but that we may have the courage to always try to follow them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us now pause for a moment and make our own prayers. God, our Heavenly Father, through your Son Jesus Christ, you have taught us that ask and thou shalt receive. We have asked and offered our prayers in faith, and we hope that through the name of Jesus we may receive what we need, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in all humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquities. Cleanse me from all my sins. Pray now, brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
And may the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. May these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that, just as we believe the saints to be already assured in immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation. We make this our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already gives you eternal praise. Towards her, we eagerly hasten as pilgrims advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the Church, through whom you give us, in our frailty, both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with a multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Boutit Lagali, our Archbishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. As we adore you, O God, who alone are holy and wonderful in all your saints, we implore your grace so that coming to perfect holiness in the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquet of your heavenly homeland. We make this our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bow now your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, the glory and joy of all the saints who has caused you to be strengthened by means of their outstanding prayers, bless you with unending blessings.
Amen.
Free through the intercession from this present ills and formed by the example of their holy way of life, may you be ever devoted to serving God and your neighbor.
Amen.
So that together with all, you may possess the joys of the homeland where Holy Church rejoices that her children are admitted in perpetual peace to the company of the citizen of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And have a nice Sunday.
Thank you. Thank you, Father.
The revelation comes, and when the red